Hey everybody, Jem Schofield here with AbelCine, and today we're going to be talking about this microphone, the RØDE VideoMic Pro Plus. Now this mic has its lineage in terms of where it came from the original VideoMic, which was then updated to the VideoMic Pro, which has these Rycote shock mounts. They've carried those through to this Pro Plus version, and there are some considerable improvements in this microphone if you're used to using this either with mirrorless, DSLRs, or small digital cinema cameras. This is a super cardioid pickup pattern microphone. It is a mic that you could use as an on-camera microphone, you could use it as a boomed mic, and also it is an excellent choice when you are just setting up a microphone for scratch audio. Now, some of the improvements here, for me, let's just take a look at number one, my favorite. It has to do with the battery system. We have a door here, which is permanently attached to the VideoMic Pro Plus. And inside of here, which comes with the mic, we have a rechargeable battery. When you actually charge this battery, it will last for up to 100 hours, which is kind of ridiculous. And you charge it with a micro USB port here, and it comes with the cable for the actual charging itself. That said, if you're on set and you either forgot to charge the battery or for some reason the battery runs out, you can use standard AA batteries with this camera system, which really increases the versatility of the mic itself. A couple of other things that I really like about this microphone, let me just go ahead and place the battery back in here. So if we just go ahead and turn on the microphone here, and we can see that that's on, we now can cycle through some of the options that we have. So over here, we have our low cut filters, and we have a 75 hertz, and then a 150, and then we can turn that off. And we can very simply activate our plus minus dB options on here. The first one here is one of the things that really sets this mic apart. It's the plus 20 dB boost on here. So what that does is it bypasses the shortcomings of the preamplifiers that we oftentimes find in mirrorless and DSLR cameras. And it boosts that signal that's going to go into the camera systems. We can turn down the recording levels on these cameras, rely less on their preamplifiers, and hence get a cleaner recording. There's also an option here for an attenuator. So we have a minus 10 decibel attenuator. That's great in situations where maybe you have your recording level turned all the way down on your recording device and you're still getting clipped audio, fireworks, a car engine starting, whatever it is, so you can activate that attenuator. And then we can just go ahead and turn that off. So very, very easy in terms of the controls. And one other big upgrade in terms of the microphone itself, and that is actually the cabling. We don't have hardwired cabling into this now, so we have a removable cable. So the one that comes with it is perfect for these types of camera systems. But if you needed a longer cable because you were going to boom the mic, you wanted to get it away from the camera system on something like a little nano stand or a micro light stand and use it that way, then we can just attach a much longer cable here and we don't have to use a standard extension cable like we did with the previous VideoMic Pro. So in this configuration, we have the VideoMic Pro Plus on a boom pole. This gets it away from the camera system. And it's really easy to do that because not only do we have the cold shoe attachment on the VideoMic Pro Plus, we also have a 3/8-16 on the bottom, so it can just attach to most standard boom poles. So we actually used this recently with a school that was shooting a promotional video, and they got the mic up there and they boomed it, which was great. We also have the dead cat on here, an additional accessory, so when you're shooting outdoors and it's windy, it can help with that as well. So another way that I like to use the microphone is on a light stand. And what I have here is just a little nano or micro light stand. And I've got the RØDE VideoMic Pro Plus on here. It's attached to a ball mount. And what I love about this is that I can really adjust this to wherever I want it to be. And this really gives you the opportunity, just like with the boom pole, to get the microphone away from your camera system. We want that mic as close as possible. And it's pretty amazing what types of results you can get from a mic like this as long as you get it close enough to your talent. So there you have it. That's the RØDE VideoMic Pro Plus. And for me, definitely some major upgrades from the previous version of this microphone. This is something I have in my kit all of the time. It's really a multi-purpose microphone. And if you get it away from your camera system using a boom pole or a light stand with a ball mount, you can do even more with it. Thanks for watching.